This is what nature does if she's left alone for 50 million years. She produces a rainforest, the most complex and diverse ecosystem on Earth. While covering only 4% of the Earth's land surface, the Amazon rainforest is home to nearly half of the world's plant and animal species. This vast forest stabilizes the global climate, moderating temperatures, absorbing rainfall, and releasing vital currents of moisture into the air. It is said that the forest gives up her secrets slowly and only to those who come to her in reverence and respect. The indigenous people of the tropical forest have evolved a rich and complex relationship with the natural world. For thousands of years, these people have lived as an integral thread in this miraculous and fragile weave of life.
Hello, 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 hello. My goodness, Morgan Freeman's voice, please. More of that all the time. My name is Una Chaplin, and normally we would all be gathered together somewhere in person, in the flesh. We would be breathing the same air. We'd be smelling each other's sweat. We'd be, I don't know, like seeing somebody that we may recognize from that other party at that other thing. But COVID has changed things. It's changed things a lot. So now we're doing this way. So I would firstly like to thank the great, great mystery for this day, for everything that we're learning. And I would like to thank the sacred internet for helping us come together against all odds. It's fast enough, don't you think? And also, I would like to thank all of you for tuning in from your homes, from wherever you are. I hope that you're really taking good care of yourselves in this time and taking good care of all your loved ones too. So we're here to make a journey to the heart of the forest, to the magic, to the mystery, the jaguars, the harpy eagles, the acai bowls, but also to the heartache and the dangers and the grief and the way that we all connect there. And you know, COVID is proving to be the great connector in this time. It has isolated us, but it has also made us see that we are all together floating on the same ball of beauty somewhere out in space. And yet COVID is also leaving a devastating mark in our precious Amazon rainforest. And that's why we're here. We're gathered here to bring you the voices and the images and music from all over the world in support of the Amazon Emergency Fund. This is a historic alliance of organizations, indigenous, non-indigenous organizations that have all come together to address this crisis. The fund supports rapid response grants for urgent and immediate prevention and care, for food and medical supplies, for emergency communications and evacuation, for protection and security for the forest guardians, and food sovereignty, really important thing that, food sovereignty and community resistance. So 100% of each donation will go directly to indigenous and forest communities and organizations that face COVID-19 in the Amazon rainforest today. But before we start, we have the blessing of a prayer from Mapu and Inca Yuba of the Huniquim people in Brazil. The Huniquim people are great teachers of mine. I've been working with these guys for about 7 years. So let's just take this moment, you know, to land here together and to begin our journey into the forest.
Eu quero agradecer ao Grande Espírito, a todos os nossos seres ancestrais. Eu sou Mapu Huniquim, do povo Huniquim da Amazônia, do Acre. Estou aqui junto com meu sobrinho Incaiubã, um líder espiritual que trabalha com as medicinas sagradas, que canta os nossos rezos sagrados. Então, estou muito agradecido por fazer parte e participar desse grande evento junto com toda a Irmandade, que a gente possa unir força e salvar a Amazônia. Porque a Amazônia, o povo indígena, está precisando do apoio de vocês, da ajuda de vocês. Então, ficamos muito felizes por estar sendo convidado e por fazer parte nesse momento, de fazer essa cantoria, de poder realmente rezar pela humanidade, pelo planeta Terra, e realmente a gente se conectar e ouvir o que a Pachamama está dizendo para nós. E através dos nossos rezos, nós poder realmente mandar muita paz e amor. Então, eu vou estar fazendo o rezo aqui, já desde agora, para que a gente possa estar conectado com o Grande Espírito. Oxalá, oxalá.
Haush, haush, gratidão, gratidão, Chai. Beautiful, thank you. And now we have a message from Lizardo Cauper, who's the president of AIDESEP, which is Peru's national indigenous organization. Lizardo. Lizardo? Right, we'll hear from Lizardo later, apparently. And so I wanted to talk about something that I hold really dear to my heart, and that is that you can't protect what you don't care about, right? Why would you? You can't do it. Not do it effectively anyway. And the thing is that you can't care about something that you can't experience. So this is what we're gonna do here. Over the next 2.5 hours, this amazing team of people have come together to do our best and worked really hard to bring you a direct experience of the Amazon. We're going to sing to its beauty. We're going to meet her people. We're going to show you the threats to its existence and what that means for the whole of life on Earth. And we're going to celebrate the cultures that have been taking care of this heart of our planet for thousands and thousands of years. So even though you may never get to go there physically, by the end, I really hope that you realize that the air that you breathe and the water that you drink and the health of the planet that we all stand on and we all share is intrinsically connected to this living legacy of creation, the Amazon rainforest. And that makes it all of our responsibilities to stand up to protect it. But hang on. How do you protect a rainforest? I don't know how to protect a rainforest. Do you? No offense, but I think you probably don't. So this is the thing, right? We need to listen to the people who do know, the people that know how it works down there, and we need to show up for them in a really good way. And tonight, that's what we're doing. Tonight, we're showing that we stand together with the protectors. So we're kind of protecting the protectors of the rainforest. So thank you so much. We are so happy that you're joining us and participating in the first ever virtual global call to action to unite with the indigenous people of the Amazon rainforest. So here we go.
Well, this is kind of a weird backdrop to use for talking about the Amazon rainforest, but I don't know. I guess we're going through some pretty weird times, so maybe it'll make some kind of strange sense. First thing I'd like you to do is I want you to bring your attention to the tree. Take a deep breath. Oxygen. Oh, yeah. Don't you dig oxygen, man? Yeah. All right. Now, bring your attention to 400 billion trees. That's the Amazon rainforest, one of the greatest expressions of life on Earth for the last 55 million years. It helps regulate our climate, is home to most of the world's terrestrial biodiversity, and gives us 20% of the world's oxygen. Now, the Amazon rainforest. The Amazon rainforest and its people are in peril right now. The indigenous people of Amazonia have kept an ecological way of life alive, and they are the key to protecting and sustainably managing the rainforest. They work every day to protect an entire ecosystem from a world that seeks to obliterate the sensitive forests for short-term profits. At the turn of the 20th century, colonists destroyed more than 90 indigenous tribes, and with them, centuries of accumulated knowledge. As their homelands continue to be destroyed by deforestation, rainforest peoples are also disappearing. We need your help. We need your help to mobilize urgent COVID-19 responses to preserve the wisdom of Amazonian elders who are at particular risk during this pandemic. The rainforest and the cultural practices developed by its inhabitants are an ancient system that is irreplaceable. Indigenous peoples around the world, they already know how connected we all are, no matter where we all live and no matter when in time. Think about it. Over 100 billion people have walked the surface of this earth before us, and we live with their past choices. We are 7 billion people right now, and we can choose to do the right thing. I want to encourage you to not only donate, please do that, but also engage on a deeper level. Make saving the rainforest personal. I've made it personal. Years ago, I joined the board of a wonderful organization called the Amazon Conservation Team. And we know that the destruction of the rainforest is a major driver of climate change. So protecting it and its indigenous peoples, that benefits all of us. That's why the Amazon Conservation Team has already placed more than 2 tons of sanitary and medical supplies into the hands of the Amazonian peoples. And that's why we are honored to join forces with our other colleagues at the Amazon Emergency Fund to help protect these peoples and these rainforests. And, well, protect ourselves. Yeah, protect all of us. I'd like you to listen to what Mark Plotkin, president of the Amazon Conservation Team, has to say.
Hi, Dr. Mark Plotkin here from the Amazon Conservation Team. We work in partnership with 55 tribes to map, manage, and improve protection of 80 million acres of ancestral rainforest. As an ethnobotanist who's been working in Amazonia for almost 40 years, I know these plants and these peoples hold secrets to healing that we have yet to understand. But we all know in the age of COVID-19 that these peoples and these forests are being hammered. I encourage everyone to join forces with us to support the Amazon Emergency Fund. In so doing, we protect these forests, we protect these medicines, we protect these indigenous peoples who are the best stewards of these forests and these healing secrets. And in so doing, we protect ourselves as well.
What's good? My name is Butterscotch, and I'm going to be performing my song called We Are All We Got. And it's about coming together when the world needs us most. Here we go.
More than half of our world is sinking in debt. We're trapped in a system that has never done us good, but we keep on rising. Gotta get about the hood to concern with politician. Change starts with us. We've come too far to be in the back of the bus. Not just talking black, all colors included. Nobody on earth deserves to be excluded. From my people in the Amazon, my people in the ghetto, to my people with the trailer parks living in the middle, where everyone deserves a chance to see a change in their world. We owe a bright future to every boy and girl. I'm sick of seeing the same news. It's time to put it to a stop. I'm never quitting on the clock, cause you and I are all we got. Come on.
We are all we got.
We're all we got.
We are all we got.
We're all we got.
Yeah.
We are all
we got.
We are all we got.
We are all we got.
Olá, gente. Eu sou a Sônia Guajajara. Eu sou da coordenação executiva da APIB, a Articulação dos Povos Indígenas do Brasil. Sou liderança indígena da Amazônia Maranhense. E eu falo aqui hoje dessa Amazônia, essa Amazônia que habita em mim, essa Amazônia que somos nós, povos indígenas, que sangra quando vê suas árvores serem cortadas ou o minério sendo arrancado da Mãe Terra, que chora quando vê as lideranças indígenas serem mortas por defender a vida, que sente o corpo envenenado pelo agrotóxico do agronegócio, que sente as chamas do fogo quando essa Amazônia é queimada. Há uma destruição programada em curso. O governo brasileiro odeia nós, povos indígenas. Ele quer apagar a nossa história e quer nos exterminar. O governo brasileiro detesta o meio ambiente protegido. Já são mais de 20 mil garimpeiros ilegais somente no território indígena Yanomami, no estado de Roraima. O desmatamento cresce a galope. A grilagem de terras está sendo tramitada no Congresso Nacional para ser legalizada. A Covid-19 já matou centenas de indígenas somente na Amazônia brasileira. Parece que estamos no meio de uma guerra que aparenta não ter fim, mas nós não vamos recuar. E nós contamos com vocês. Precisamos chamar mais gente que acreditam que é possível resistir frente a esse projeto de destruição. E convidamos todas e todas que acreditam numa sociedade mais justa e mais igualitária. A Amazônia somos todos nós, artistas pela Amazônia. Estamos juntos. Precisamos unir essa força. Sangue indígena, nenhuma gota a mais.
Hi everyone, my name is Wade Davis, and I'm delighted to be with you, and I can't thank you enough for supporting the Amazon Emergency Fund. You know, COVID has become a global crisis, but the peoples of the Amazon, the small, isolated indigenous societies in particular, are especially vulnerable. And this wouldn't be the first time that foreign diseases had threatened the ways of the forest. Remember that at the time of the European conquest, diseases such as smallpox and measles swept over the Americas, and they didn't decimate the peoples of the Amazon, because decimate would imply to kill 1 in 10. It was quite the opposite. Fully 90% of the people of the Amazon, 10 million strong, we now know, succumbed to these foreign diseases. And even the Spanish and Portuguese were bewildered by the rates of mortality and morbidity of these ailments that they knew well from Europe, ailments that most Europeans were exposed to almost as a passage rite, as part of coming of age. And they simply didn't understand that these Amerindian populations were completely susceptible to diseases that were commonplace in Europe. But today we do understand, and we do know, and if we allow COVID to sweep over the Amazon, wreaking havoc in the lives of these visionary peoples of the forest, the responsibility will be on our shoulders. We know more than we did in the 16th century, and we can do more. We have to garner the resources to protect the people of the Amazon rainforest. So thanks so much for being part of this effort, and together we really can make a difference.
כשאת לא איתי אין טעם כמעט אני אש בלי אור סתרה בלי כוכב כוכב בליל כפור בלי זוג מאוהב אל האישה מורדות הדרכים סירה ללא ים שדה בלי פרחים העצב תמידי עצב חתום אם אינך לצידי אז אני לא כלום
Ser nossa vida braços precisam dos teus. Meus abraços precisam dos teus. Estou tão sozinha. Tenho os olhos cansados de olhar para o além.
Deforestation in the Brazilian rainforest has increased by 50% since the pandemic took hold. Reduced oversight in remote regions has made it easier for loggers and mineral mining to go unchecked. Global climate change and the dramatic increase in deforestation have caused one of the driest rainy seasons in years. So the fires last summer that devastated the forests are on track to repeat again this year. More fires, should they occur in August and September of this year, put the Amazon on a further collision course with disaster. In this critical time of international health crisis, protecting the heart of the planet is the same as protecting our own heart. Please join me in supporting the Amazon Emergency Fund and demand a halt to extractive activity and deforestation on indigenous territories across the Amazon. Thank you.
This is a moment like no other in history. It's a moment when many millions of us have slowed down, and millions of us are thinking more deeply about the way we live. That is why I started Eco-Resolution with Advaya, to encourage all of us to explore how we can live in better harmony with the earth, each other, and ourselves. The indigenous peoples of the Amazon already know how to live in harmony with the earth, yet right now they are threatened twice over. COVID-19 has spread to indigenous communities which are especially vulnerable to disease, and many thousands of cases have been confirmed. At the same time, destructive deforestation in the Amazon is increasing. These wisdom keepers of the forest protect and defend the Amazon for all of us. It's up to us to support them, and we can do that right now by giving to the Amazon Emergency Fund. I urge you to support as generously as you can to help provide rapid response supplies like food, medical care, emergency communications, and evacuation, and help with protection and community resilience across the Amazon region. Beyond that, if we really want to safeguard life on Earth, we must make it illegal to destroy ecosystems like the Amazon. Mass damage and destruction of nature is called ecocide, and it should be an international crime, just like genocide. That's why I signed up to the Stop the Ecocide campaign, working with lawyers and researchers and diplomats to make ecocide a crime at the International Criminal Court. So I invite you to make an eco resolution to right now support the Amazon Emergency Fund and to sign up to help stop ecocide. It's time to change the rules so that we can truly protect people and the planet. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Sebastian Salgado, a Brazilian photographer, and I want to invite you to join an important group of international personalities in an appeal to the Brazilian government. What has brought these people together is fear that the terrible coronavirus, which is spreading rapidly across Brazil, will have a devastating impact on the indigenous peoples of the Amazon region. Brazil has the largest number of isolated native peoples in the world, and over the past 500 years, they have been victims of successive devastating epidemics because they have no defense against diseases coming from outside the rainforest. Their situation today is still more critical because the Brazilian government has relaxed its controls on gold diggers, loggers, and farmers who are invading land reserved for the indigenous tribes. And these fortune hunters may carry the coronavirus. That is why we are urging the President of Brazil and the leaders of its legislative and judicial branches to create a special task force to drive illegal invaders from indigenous territories and to guarantee the health and welfare of the native population. Brazil owes it to these first Brazilians. They need our help. The time to act is now.
Hermanos y hermanas, que en la Amazonía, nuestros 420 pueblos indígenas, nuestros 3 millones de personas, de familias que habitamos la Amazonía, estamos viviendo un momento muy difícil, muy complejo. En primer lugar, por la invasión de nuestros territorios. En segundo lugar, por la contaminación de los ríos y las montañas de nuestra Amazonía, que tiene 7 millones de kilómetros cuadrados. Hoy, la minería ilegal, el extractivismo, la deforestación, los incendios, están destruyendo la Amazonía. Pero hoy también se suma la pandemia del COVID. Y es por eso que hoy les pedimos a ustedes su cooperación, su apoyo humano, moral, económico, para salvar a nuestros pueblos, para salvar la biodiversidad, para salvar nuestro territorio. Y hoy aspiramos que con el apoyo de ustedes hagamos realidad nuestro Fondo de Emergencia Internacional por la Amazonía. Háganlo por la humanidad, por uno de los pulmones del planeta, pero también por nuestros pueblos y naciones de la Amazonía.
Wow, thank you so much, all of you. This is the thing, right? And it comes, you see all of this, and it comes from being just concepts of the Amazon, this place that's very far away, to then it being a personal issue here. It's a personal issue. We're dealing with people. And, you know, that's one of the things that our brother there was just saying, you know, is that this is not just about saving the lungs of the world so that we can all live and save ourselves. This is about people and saving humanity and stepping up to the plate in this historic time of change. So thank you, all of you, for staying with us. You know, this is going to get a little intense at times, and I strongly advise that you get up and dance at any given opportunity that you can. You know, Butterscotch was thrown down there. So, you know, just get up and celebrate as well. It's not just about holding our hearts in grief, but also about celebrating life. So let's do that. And so get up and move around. Thank you so much for those powerful images and words. My God. Oh, by the way, Sonia is a legend. I marched with her in New York and then we went dancing, and she is such a powerhouse. And when she talks about this respectful relationship that we forge with the natural world, she does it with a certainty that we can actually change course. This is the thing. We can actually change and reshape our connection to the planet and to each other. Well, we can do it now. How do we want to step back out into the world? I mean, look at this right now, what's happening. There's so many distant lands coming together to bring you this live stream. We're just in Israel, now we'll go to California, Ghana, Brazil. Voices from all generations, from all cultures speak and sing to the heart of this planet, the heart that connects us all. So stay with it and get up and dance when you can so that you can better receive the messages of the heart.
Meu nome é Lalela Roichai Suruí, jovem mulher indígena do povo Paité Suruí de Rondônia, e eu venho aqui falar da importância do apoio internacional para os povos indígenas do Brasil e da Amazônia nesse momento tão difícil que é a pandemia do coronavírus. Além de estar tendo que lutar contra a doença do coronavírus que já chegou nas aldeias, os povos indígenas também estão tendo que enfrentar a luta contra o ataque às suas terras, as constantes invasões que vem sofrendo e a luta contra esse governo genocida, antiambientalista e antipovos indígenas que constantemente vem atacando nossos direitos. Então é importantíssimo o apoio de vocês, o apoio aos povos indígenas nesse momento tão difícil.
Manaus is the capital of the Amazonas state in Brazil. It is the heart of what you know as the Amazon rainforest.
And what I know as home.
The Amazon rainforest is the largest rainforest on Earth,
with the greatest biodiversity.
And the largest freshwater repository.
Home of incredible cultures and magical stories.
Extraordinary animals and unbelievable lives.
We are under attack.
We are dying.
We are dying.
We are dying.
Manaus is the epicenter of the COVID-19 in the Amazon rainforest.
And its health system will not collapse.
Because it has already collapsed.
Our infrastructure can't handle.
All those migrants heading to Manaus every day.
Looking for treatment and a chance to live.
Adults, teenagers, children and babies.
More than 100 families are losing their loved ones every day.
But this number could be much smaller if the hospitals had the basic necessary infrastructure.
We need your help.
The traditional people of the Amazon need your help.
The Amazon rainforest needs your help.
Our future needs your help.
Help from countries that have already gone through the worst part of COVID-19.
If your health system has already been through the peak of this pandemic, please help the Amazonia.
There are multiple ways to contribute. Manaus hospitals are lacking medicines, respirators, and basic protection items.
And if you are unable to provide great quantities of supplies, keep in mind that even the smallest of actions can have a huge positive impact on people's lives.
Just please, don't refrain from trying to help us. Don't abandon us in this crucial moment. We beg the parliaments and the governments of the countries watching this. You can help avoid an irreversible tragedy.
because a massacre is going to happen.
We must defend the traditional people from invaders that can lead them to their deaths.
We must defend them from our federal government's neglective and irresponsible actions.
And now we must protect them from this lethal virus.
The consequences of the Amazon people's death and the destruction of the Amazon rainforest will be global.
Global leaders, please help us.
Anyone that can, please help.
Salving a Amazônia.
Salving a Amazônia.
Salving a Amazônia.
Salving a Amazônia.
Salve
a Amazônia.
Salvem a Amazônia.
Olá a todos, eu sou Eric Terena, DJ e produtor de música eletrônica, membro da Mídia Índia. Eu quero aqui agradecer aos artistas globais unidos pela Amazônia que hoje estão fazendo esse festival, um momento muito importante onde nós, povos indígenas, precisamos da colaboração de vocês do mundo. A gente está passando por um momento muito difícil de pandemia e não é a primeira vez que nós, povos indígenas, passamos por esse momento em nossos territórios e é com a colaboração de vocês que a gente pode combater o coronavírus e também a invasão dos nossos territórios. A gente segue junto nessa luta por meio da música, da cultura, da arte, sangue indígena, nenhuma gota mais.
Piali, Kentimawika, Nanatoka Xiuteskat, Tanatiu. My name is Xiuteskat. My people are the Mexica peoples of Mexico Tenochtitlan. I'm an artist, I'm a rapper, I'm an organizer with Earth Guardians, and I'm grateful to be a part of this broadcast alongside so many other powerful artists and visionaries and voices out there who are lending their platform to speak on an absolutely critical issue that is truly connecting each and every one of us. Since the beginning of this pandemic, we have seen across the globe how marginalized and frontline communities have experienced the worst of the impacts of this pandemic. That the systems of injustice and oppression across the globe continue to threaten our ways of life, our ability to protect our own land. I am grateful to be standing in solidarity with the indigenous communities of the Amazon in this dire moment where, as a global community, this can be a point where we pivot and we change and transform our relationship with our indigenous relatives as allies, as artists, as storytellers, as supporters, as everyday people. From this moment forward, we are calling on everybody to support and use your voice, use your platform, use your social media to help spread awareness around the impacts of this pandemic in indigenous communities in the Amazon and the greater work of stopping extractive industries from coming and exploiting indigenous territories, which ultimately affects each and every one of us. So again, thank you everybody for playing your part, for being a part of this. And I'm excited, I'm gonna share a couple verses that I feel like are relevant to this moment. And the first one starts, says, Yo quiero que me entierre como mis antepasados. Regresar a la tierra todo que me ha dado. A mi gente, a la tierra de mis ancestros. Tengo sangre mexica, regreso a mi pueblo. Regreso de nuevo, desde el suelo al cielo. Traigo en mi boca la palabra de mis abuelos. Con mis pies en la tierra, mi visión hacia el sol. Y soy un guerrero buscando lo que se perdió. Yo perdí mi idioma, se perdió mi papá, las fronteras en su mente todavía hay que cruzar. En el viento oscuro, en una vasija de barro, yo quiero que me entierre como mis antepasados. My people have been singing with their hands up. You could show yourself out if you came to see something average. We came as a family, not an industry standard. I'd rather drown together than leave my fam behind. Without them, I wouldn't have shit. I hope you can feel the magic. I'm living life grounded, steady, finding a balance. Raised by warriors, ready for any challenge. You hype on the small swells, we were born to rob mavericks. This is the turning of the tides. There I was, 6 years old, my eyes wide open. I saw the storm, city swallowed up by the ocean. Humanity messed up, look at the world broken. I wanna see the borders open. I wrote this music, it was something I found hoping. My generation finally seeing the web woven. Everything is connected, my generation was chosen. To guide the way, to the light. You see, this is our movement. We walk on roads paved by every great leader of every revolution. We doing it our way. And this is a celebration. If love is resistance, resisting is in our nature. We'll show up by the thousands, people of every nation. We'll summit the highest mountain to prove to them we can make it. It starts right here, right now. Every one of you has light within. Now is the time to shine out. Hands up if you feel it too. This music is a movement. It's proof if you feel it moving you, because the power of the people is more powerful than people in power. I believe that this can be our finest hour.
We're living through dark times, socially, politically, and environmentally. Wars, threat of wars, the use of nuclear weapons, violence, migrants, poverty, all caused by our lack of respect for each other and the materialistic, unsustainable lifestyles and lack of spirituality and lust for power in which so many of us are caught up. We're in the midst of a major pandemic and we face a climate crisis. Both of these are being caused by our lack of respect for the natural world, the environment, and the other animals who inhabit planet Earth. It is desperately important that we join hands around the world and take action, each one of us, now, before it's too late.
Hello people, my name is Rocky Dawuni and I'm coming to you live and direct from Ghana. I am doing this song in support of all the indigenous people in the Amazon and their fight to protect their homeland, their fight to protect their way of living, their fight to protect this incredible resource that is for all of humanity. So today we all stand with you in your fight. This song is called Road to Destiny.
Oh na 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 na. Oh na 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 na. Yeah. I'm rolling like a leaf blowing in the wind. There is no place I move to call my home. I struggle just to make it through on the road to destiny. My mama said, son, don't you ever give anything you can't afford to lose. Men will try to seize control of your own in destiny. Destiny, 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 destiny. Run, run, run as fast as I can. I can't outrun my fate. Destiny, destiny, let me. Have I asked? The answers don't amount to solutions, but I never give up hope on the road to destiny. For time is always right to do what is right. With all my might, I strive to write a chapter in this book of life on the road to destiny. We're still up to no good. Caught up in your false pretense on the road to destiny. So come on, people, seize the time. We are the ones we've been waiting for. On this road to destiny. Destiny, destiny, destiny. Destiny, destiny, let me be destiny.
Hello, everyone. I hope you're enjoying this live stream so far. I'm Atossa Soltani, the founder and president of Amazon Watch, and we're here to support the Amazon Emergency Fund. And also, I'm very excited to be introducing you to one of the foremost experts in the Amazon, Dr. Carlos Nobre. He's an earth system and climate scientist, senior scientist with the University of Sao Paulo. And we are very lucky to have him here talking with us today. Welcome, Carlos.
My pleasure, Atossa, and congratulations for creating the very important Amazon Emergency Fund.
People have been hearing about the importance of the Amazon as the lungs of the earth. And, you know, your science has been showing that it's, you know, it's a vital organ, but it's more like a heart of the planet. Could you say more about the importance of the Amazon and the climate system of the planet?
Well, the Amazon forest is the largest tropical forest on the planet. It's almost the size of Australia. And it is a kind of a biological heart for the planet because it holds the largest biodiversity on Earth, also supports the climate stabilization. It's a very important mechanism. The Amazon forest recycles water very efficiently. It rains year-round. And that climate forest interactions maintain this immense biodiversity and stabilize the climate. It holds a huge amount of carbon. And if we lose that carbon, it will end up in the atmosphere as a greenhouse gas and really making it almost impossible to reach the goals of the Paris Agreement to combat climate crisis. So the Amazon is really an essential biospheric element for us to be able to maintain the planet and to find sustainable ways for the planet. And with the COVID-19, the tropical forests become even more important. They hold the largest amount of microorganisms, viruses, bacteria, and other pathogens. So we have to keep that ecological balance if we want actually even to pursue a maintenance of our human health.
Carlos, with the destruction of the Amazon and the current, you know, the fire season last year was just heartbreaking. It really woke up the world to the immense crisis, deforestation crisis that's facing the Amazon. And with that increased deforestation, and you know, we saw not just Brazil, but also Bolivia lost something like 40% of its dry tropical forests. We saw such immense impact of those fires. And we were already worried about the tipping point. Could you say more about what is the tipping point and what's basically, where are we at with respect to this tipping point?
Unfortunately, Atossa, we are very close to an irreversible tipping point. We are seeing in southern Amazon, from all the way from southern Peru, Bolivia, and southern Brazilian Amazon, all the way to the Atlantic coast. This is almost 50%, 40% of the whole Amazon forest, we are seeing that the forest is becoming drier. The dry season, which is very short all over, it's becoming longer, 1 month longer today than 40 years ago. We are seeing the Amazon forest losing trees, tree mortality in some species are increasing. And we are seeing this tremendous, powerful water recycling of the forest decreasing rapidly in this large portion. So we are really at the edge of this cliff, of this irreversible tipping point. So if we don't stop deforestation immediately, if we don't stop global warming urgently, in a few, perhaps 15, 20, 25 years, we are going to cross this tipping point and 50, 60% of the Amazon will become a degraded tropical savanna. We are going to lose a huge amount of carbon to the atmosphere, but also we are going to lose the largest biodiversity on Earth. The Amazon biodiversity can make thousands of different products, so it can sustain a very developed economy, benefiting the Amazonian people, but benefiting the planet.
Thank you so much, Carlos. I've learned so much from you, and I'm very inspired by this idea of an economy that puts life at the center, a life-centric economic system for the whole planet, but in particular for a place as important as the Amazon, which is, you know, like you have shown through your work, is not just an important forest, it's actually a vital organ of the Earth system. Thank you so much for this interview. I want to invite our viewers. It's time for all hands on deck to save lives of our indigenous brothers and sisters in the Amazon. They are the protectors of this great biome, and they are protecting it for not just themselves, but for the future of all of humanity. I invite everyone here to join the Amazon Emergency Fund to make a contribution to support COVID response. We are working together in this critical moment. Join us and enjoy the rest of the live stream. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hello, good people. My name is Chloe Smith from the band Rising Appalachia. And we stand in solidarity with the people of the Amazon and the Amazon forest in this event, protecting the protectors, which is more important now than ever in these difficult times. So I wanted to lend my voice and our movement and missions and actions and attention to this movement. Artists for Amazon, the Amazon Emergency Relief Fund. All of these things are so important in bringing us together and supporting our people down south. So I'm going to play a song for you all called Resilient, which is about all of these things, standing up for what you believe in, coming back to one's original form after being bent or broken, and finding the strength in hard times. So here's the song. I am resilient. I trust the movement. I negate the chaos. Uplift the negative. I'll show up at the table again and again and again. I'll close my mouth and learn to listen. These times are poignant, the winds have shifted. It's all we can do to stay uplifted. Pipelines through backyards, wolves howling out front. Yeah, I got my crew, but truth is what I want. Realigned and on point, power to the peaceful. prayers to the waters, women at the center, all vessels open to give and receive. Let's see the system bow down to its knees. Whoa, 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 taught me that I'm a speck of dust and this world was made for me, so let's go and try our luck, say. I've got my roots down, 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 deep. I've got my roots down, 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 deep. So what are we doing here? What has been done? What are you gonna do about it when the world comes undone? My voice feels tiny, and I'm sure so does yours. Put us all together, make a mighty roar. Roar, 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 roar. Trust the movement, I negate the chaos, uplift the negative. I'll show up at the table again and again and again. I'll close my mouth and learn to listen. In solidarity with the Amazon, one love, y'all.
It's time to protect the protectors. When we stand with them as they fight for their rights and territories, we are also protecting ourselves and the planet. As for the fight to protect ourselves in these times, we're hearing so many horrific stories here in the United States about COVID-19 outbreaks inside our country's meatpacking plants. One of the largest of these, JBS, happens to be a Brazilian company and is the world's largest producer of beef. With cattle ranching and grazing being the leading drivers of deforestation in the Brazilian rainforest, it has never been clearer how our personal health is connected to the food we eat and to those who grow and process that food. Lives are in the balance. Inside the Amazon, inside our meat processing plants, inside our homes, we are all connected now. There is before this and after this. In this critical time of an international health crisis, protecting the heart of the planet is the same as protecting our own hearts. Please join me in supporting the Amazon Emergency Fund and demand a halt to extractive activity and deforestation on indigenous territories across the Amazon. We can do this. Now, today, together. Thank you.
There is so much pain and suffering in the world right now. This crisis is showing us the importance of solidarity to put life over profit and the importance of the natural world. It's showing us how connected we are as humans. The pandemic has now reached the Amazon rainforest, and indigenous people are escaping the virus deeper into the forests. It's not the first time that we as Indigenous people are facing a new disease, but it's the first time that the forest may no longer be the safest place. Human-driven climate change, massive floods, has destroyed Indigenous communities, people's homes, and fields. Massive oil spills has contaminated drinking water. Mining projects, deforestation, and oil development projects continue to threaten Indigenous people's ability to live off the land. And this affects Indigenous women specially because we are the caregivers of our children, our families, and our communities. There are no hospitals in our communities, no government aid. We stand on our own. And in the face of lack of attention from governments, Indigenous women and Indigenous organizations are taking the matter into their own hands, producing and distributing information on preventative measures of COVID-19, as well as management plans, putting their own health at risk. At the same time, Indigenous people are calling on the protection of Mother Earth and the Amazon rainforest. We need to heal this planetary wound. We need to protect those people who are protecting the Amazon rainforest, the world climate, and Mother Earth. We need to protect Indigenous people. Thank you.
Hi, we're the Brothers Koran, and we're honored to be here standing in solidarity and care for the Earth, moving out of a culture of greed and moving into a world of change and a world that works for everyone. This song is a dedication and a request that the leaders of our time heed our call for change. It's called Everything's Changing.
Time moves slowly. I watch my feet. I watch my feet as I'm falling into the moment. I burn like queen. You played my heart, played my heart to the potion. Generation.
Our mission is to hear the world's song one voice at a time. We ask that all of the protectors of the rainforest speak up, use their voice, and empower yourselves. And let's protect those protectors and protect their voices. And let's hear them out. Sing after me in your homes. Ready?
Ah, oh, oh, oh. Ah.
now.
Hoje a floresta está triste. Os rios estão secando. Os pássaros não cantam mais, só sabem chorar. O céu sangra e as borboletas voam para longe. Na minha aldeia, as crianças ardem febre e queimam até mesmo o sopro do pajé. Somos sobreviventes, precisamos viver. Somos o grito da floresta. Somos os peixes subindo a correnteza. Somos a revoada das araras no pôr do sol. Somos os filhos dessa terra. A floresta é nossa. E nós somos a floresta. No mar, na Inecã.
Thank you so much, my goodness. So we are getting an abundance of people requesting to donate, and I just wanted to point you in the right direction. Go to the emergency, AmazonEmergencyFund.org. AmazonEmergencyFund.org. Go there, donate, be generous. This is a really big deal. Thank you guys so much. And this is the crazy thing, right? We're all in this place where our lives are changed, and we are feeling all of the effects of this global transition, and we're all dealing with a lot of grief and uncertainty. I mean, COVID's a really terrible, confusing thing. It's infected the world with fear and grief and uncertainty. And these feelings, they can be quite new and unfamiliar to many of us around the world, but these feelings are not new and familiar to the indigenous people of the Amazon rainforest. And this is the thing, this is a time for us to come together, you know, this is why we're doing it. It's not like, oh, let's look at all of these terrible things that are also happening apart from the things that are already happening in our lives. But this is a demonstration that we really do need to act on these feelings. We know something is wrong, you know? But I just want to give you a little bit of history here. And a lot of you know this, so forgive me if I'm saying something you already know. But since the early 16th century, the colonization of the forest and its peoples has been nonstop. For 500 years, violence and arrogance and theft and destruction of the land and the people by other people who came from very far away and had no idea how things worked over there in the Amazon rainforest. And it's really been like an endless array of devastation. The true people of the Amazon, they knew that they were living, that they live inside this mysterious treasure. They know that still, and they have mad respect for it. And they also know the value of leaving certain treasures in the ground. And they know the value of keeping things in a beautiful way and keeping things in a balanced way, not taking too much, you know, reciprocity. But we have lost sight of all of these things over time, you know, putting profit above everything else, even the sanctity of life, which is really crazy. And this is what is threatening us today. So what now, right? We have become used to this way that we live. You know, we take this all for granted. I include myself in that equation completely. And yet our culture of comfort, our culture of being comfortable, it relies on a culture of extraction. And that is powered by greed. And that drives the drilling of the oil and the mining of the minerals and the cutting down of the forest, which brings the Amazon every single day closer to collapse. But I do not consent. I do not consent. And neither, you don't have to either, you know? This is why we're here, so stay with us. I know this is difficult and emotional, and there's a lot of information here, but there is so much more to come. And just really take in this music, take in the opportunity to feel the celebration of the natural world. So feel the music so that you can really take in all of the messages that we're receiving from our family across the world. And donate at the Emergency Amazon Relief Fund, AmazonEmergencyReliefFund.org.
My name is Ivan Lentz. I'm a Brazilian songwriter and musician. I'm here to play a song for you that is called My Country. In Portuguese, Meu País. And it's a song about the beauty of my country and the pain we feel when something is going badly, like is going now. Our government, using the coronavirus situation, is not protecting our tribes, our Indians. So it looks like they want to exterminate them and evade their territories to put fire, exactly like they are doing with the rainforests. This is really bad. For us, it is a crime, and we need to stop them. We have to stop them. So that's why we are here, asking for you to help us, to support us. Please help the Amazon, the rainforest, and our Indians. We need you.
aqui é meu país. Nos seios da minha mãe, nos olhos da perdiz, na lua, na invernada, nas trilhas, estradas que vês que vão ao céu, ao coração. Aqui é meu país, de botas, cavalo, histórias, de aras e sacis, violas cantando. Vitórias, ponteiros e desafios no peito do Brasil. Me diz como ser feliz em outro lugar. Me diz como ser feliz em outro lugar. Aqui é meu país, dos sonhos sem cabimento. Aqui só um passarinho, que as penas estão dentro. Por isso aprendi a cantar, voar, voar, voar. Me diz como ser feliz em outro lugar. Me diz como ser feliz em outro lugar. Thank you.
Nietzsche's, Nietzsche's, come serve eles em outro lugar. Nietzsche's, Nietzsche's, come serve.
You gotta love Yvonne Lenz's music. Thank you, Yvonne, for that really beautiful song. I'm Herbie Hancock, and I had the honor of narrating Amazon Aid Foundation's powerful documentary called River of Gold, about the devastating impact of gold mining in the Amazonian rainforest. Unfortunately, since the start of the coronavirus pandemic, regulations have relaxed and gold mining is expanding across the Amazon. Pristine forests are being destroyed and indigenous people are being confronted with increasing violence and disease, including COVID-19. The mine workers who have come to the Amazon, many out of extreme poverty, are also vulnerable and often victimized by organized crime, including human trafficking, mercury poisoning, money laundering, and child slavery. It's up to us to ask important questions about where our gold comes from, just as we are becoming more aware of how our food and clothing is sourced. The gold we buy should not be a death sentence for the communities whose land and water are being destroyed for profit. During this critical international health crisis, we must rise together to help protect the protectors of the forest. Please join me in supporting the Amazon Emergency Fund and the moratorium on deforestation to protect the indigenous guardians of the Amazon. We can do this now, today, together. Thank you. Now we're going to watch the trailer for River of Gold.
At first glance, it's almost like looking at the Grand Canyon in America, but then when you actually start to really understand what you're looking at, it hits you even harder.
Everybody's affected because the Amazon has such an important environmental impact.
We're at that moment where if we are not acting, the scale goes in another direction. This is critical moment, you know, more than ever in history.
The Amazon is at a real crossroads. It's very close to a tipping point.
Gold mining is one of the underlying things that's destroying this enormous rainforest. It's like the Wild West.
The government launched an operation last year to destroy dredges.
Peruvian police raid illegal mining operation.
Rising global demand for gold has also fueled demand for a far less prized metal, mercury. Mercury from small-scale mines travels widely, moving up the food chain into fish and humans.
Probably more than 100 police here, and they're bringing the fight to the miners. They've come in helicopter because it's just too far to get to by foot.
Many miners are determined to fight. March 3 died while protesting against the new laws.
The price of gold reached an all-time high this month, surpassing $1,800 an ounce.
Illegal gold mining is a $2.9 billion industry, moving more money than drug trafficking. As long as the global price of gold remains high, this activity will continue.
Fortunately, we are increasingly aware of the impacts the products we consume, from cotton to coffee to paper. But sometimes we fail to understand the complexities of the larger systems our sourcing relies on and its impacts. When it comes to gold, which, by the way, is in our jewelry and our cell phones, can you explain a little bit about what small-scale gold mining is in the Amazon?
So the small-scale gold mining in the Amazon is almost all illegal gold mining. And basically, a whole bunch of poor people are looking for income, and they are exploited by those who want to buy the gold. And they essentially invade a portion of the Amazon, dig up the river systems, pollute it with mercury, invade the surrounding forest to get at the sediments underneath. And essentially, not only make that mess, but are a spearhead for all kinds of spontaneous colonization that may follow them. Mm-hmm. So that has serious biodiversity consequences. I mean, the Amazon has more biodiversity than any other terrestrial part of the planet. And it's got aquatic biodiversity, it's got terrestrial biodiversity, and all that depends on natural systems and the forest. So start to mess that up, you mess up that biodiversity.
And how is this affecting the indigenous peoples and forest defenders in particular?
So when illegal gold mining invades indigenous lands, it not only has all those ecological impacts, but it's also very likely to have very negative social impacts on the indigenous people. And to begin with, indigenous people are vulnerable to diseases which the rest of us basically have as ordinary day-to-day diseases, but when they get into indigenous peoples, they can be deadly. And it's basically infringing the basic rights of those indigenous peoples to live in their forests in the way that they choose.
And a primary driver of artisanal gold mining or small-scale gold mining in the Amazon is poverty. Can you tell us about the people that come to the Amazon to mine for gold?
So it's a very simplistic observation to say it's driven by poverty. Yes, all the people who do all that illegal gold mining are poor people. They're basically only earning twice as much as if they stayed in the Amazon and the Andean highlands, right? It's the long economic chain that's the start of. that in my view is the real culprit. And it's all illegal, and ultimately it ends up in somebody unwittingly buying some of that gold in a fancy retail shop in an urban area, you know, tens of thousands of miles away.
So Dr. Lovejoy, obviously you're an advocate for the Amazon. What are the best things we can do to support a healthy future for the area and for its people?
So the best things you can do are, first of all, buy sustainable things, particularly guilt-free gold, if we can call it that. But also learn about the Amazon, find out about the organizations working to help it, find ways that you can help them, and make it a topic of conversation. It's an important part of the way the world works and can work, and to let it sort of degrade away with no attention or no help would be just really criminal.
Thank you very much for raising our awareness of gold and of the Amazon today, Dr. Lovejoy. We're very grateful to have had the opportunity to talk with you. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
A situação do avanço da pandemia do coronavírus nos nossos territórios, nas florestas da Amazônia inteira, está em situação crítica. Está avançando, isso tem nos preocupado muito, porque isso atinge diretamente a vida das populações, dos povos indígenas que vivem e dependem de forma direta dessas florestas. Os nossos territórios pedem socorro pelo avanço não só da pandemia neste momento, mas o aumento grave, o aumento muito grande do desmatamento. O desmatamento não só acelera o avanço da pandemia aos nossos territórios, às nossas vidas, mas também ela desequilibra o nosso modo de vida, o nosso modo de viver nos territórios indígenas. Nós, povos indígenas, estamos em situação de vulnerabilidade devido à fragilidade da proteção desses territórios, devido ao avanço do coronavírus, devido ao aumento do desmatamento. É hora de juntarmos todos aqui pela proteção dos territórios, pela proteção das florestas e pela proteção da vida das pessoas que dependem diretamente dos recursos dessa floresta. É a hora de juntarmos nessa campanha. Junte-se a nós, povos indígenas, pela defesa da Amazônia, pela defesa dos nossos direitos e pela defesa da vida da humanidade com a proteção dos territórios e da Amazônia.
Hi, I'm Luciana Souza, and I'm here with my good friend, fellow Brazilian, guitarist Romero Lobambo. We all need to come together now to protect the rights and the territories of the indigenous people of the Amazon at this time of urgent need. Please join us by adding your voice and your support to this very important global effort. Here's a song by the great Ivan Lins.
Vamos lá, Lu? Aparecida, vamos lá.
Vamos lá. Thank you.
Me conta por que é que você não tem mais aquela feição, não tem mais a mesma euforia, não tem mais a mesma paixão. Desaparecida, sumir desse jeito não tem cabimento. Me conta quem foi, por que foi e tudo o que você passou. Preciso saber seu tormento, preciso saber da
homossexual. Faço parte do coletivo Tibira, que é voltada sobre a temática de indígenas LGBTs, e temos como objetivo apoiar, acolher e dar visibilidade a essa causa, que aqui no Brasil, principalmente, é praticamente invisível. Nós, povos indígenas, estamos precisando de toda ajuda e de todo apoio neste momento de pandemia e isolamento social. Nós, povos indígenas, somos mais vulneráveis à doença do não indígena. E nós, povos indígenas, queremos continuar vivos, continuar existindo e resistindo, buscando lutar pelos nossos direitos. Nós, povos indígenas, queremos salvar a Mãe Terra, que também neste momento está precisando de ajuda. A Mãe Natureza, ela precisa de nós, povos indígenas, e nós também precisamos dela. Salvar a natureza é salvar o mundo, salvar a vida dos animais, das aves e até mesmo das pessoas não indígenas. O governo atual, muitas vezes ele quer destruir a natureza, e destruir a natureza é referir a nós também, e nós não queremos que isso aconteça. Neste momento, a união, a solidariedade é capaz de salvar vidas. Muito obrigado.
Olá, eu sou Maria Gadu, sou cantora, compositora e ativista das causas indígenas. E antes de mais nada, eu queria fazer uma saudação a todos os povos originários do mundo inteiro e, sobretudo, aos parentes brasileiros, aos nossos indígenas, nossos cuidadores de tantos biomas múltiplos que o Brasil abriga, carrega e descuida. Há antes disso e depois disso muitas coisas. O Brasil vem lutando através dos povos indígenas há mais de 520 anos para que haja uma transformação de comportamento, para que a gente se sinta mais parte da natureza, se sinta mais parte dos animais. Enfim, a gente vem atravessando tempos nebulosos, desmatamento, grilagem, genocídio, e há um destempero numérico. Enquanto números aumentam, outros diminuem. Os números que aumentam são dos hectares que são desmatados na Amazônia todos os dias, e os números que diminuem são a quantidade dos povos indígenas por conta do genocídio. Então, essa conta tem que ser invertida. Nós temos que ter mais povos indígenas e menos desmatamento. E é por isso que eu agradeço a Amazon Watch pela organização dessa live com tantas pessoas que eu admiro, tantas pessoas ativistas, indígenas, artistas, unindo suas vozes a esse chamado. É um grande chamado da Mãe Terra e essa luta é de todos nós. Por meio disso, venho pedir a você que está aí ouvindo na sua casa que colabore com o Fundo de Emergência da Amazônia, que dê as mãos a todas essas pessoas, a essa causa que é sua também, e que a gente possa reverter esse quadro. Enfim, chegou nessa hora. O Brasil já sofreu muitas pandemias e essas pandemias têm uma ação muito, muito maléfica nos povos indígenas. Isso é histórico. E a Covid-19 já vem trazendo para a gente grandes tristezas, grandes perdas, e que a gente consiga reverter esse quadro. E a gente reverte esse quadro cuidando, se importando e agindo. Eu vou cantar uma canção que me emociona, que me impulsiona, do Beto Guedes e do Ronaldo Bastos, e deixo um abraço apertado, mesmo de longe, a todos vocês e a todos os parentes.
Nenhum segredo, falo desse chão da nossa casa. Vem que tá na hora de arrumar. Tempo, quero viver mais 200 anos. Quero não ferir meu semelhante, nem por isso quero me ferir. Vamos precisar de todo mundo pra banir do mundo a opressão, pra melhor juntar as nossas forças. Vamos precisar de muito amor. A felicidade mora ao lado, e quem não é tolo pode ver. A paz na terra, amor, o pé na terra, amor. A paz na terra, amor, o sal da terra. És o mais bonito dos planetas. Tão te maltratando por dinheiro, tu que és a nave, nossa irmã. Canta, leva tua vida em harmonia e nos alimenta com teus frutos. Tu que és do homem, a maçã. Vamos precisar de todo mundo. Um mais um é sempre mais que dois, para construir a vida nova. É só dividir melhor o pão. recriar o paraíso agora, para merecer quem vem depois. Deixa nascer o amor, deixa fluir o amor, deixa viver amor, deixa crescer o amor. O sal da terra, erehé inhaui.
Hello, my name is Dharma Lemon, and this is my poem called Other Side. The saying goes, the grass is greener on the other side, but through our perfectly mended fences and sewage-thick privilege, the grass is burning on the other side. On the other side, the government is just as corrupted as ours. On the other side, the president of Brazil promotes pillaging pariahs of their native land. Life is being burnt before his eyes, so naturally he sends tweets about soccer teams and leisurely sits as the trees on the other side are being cut down for rubber, soybeans, and beef. The other side is frightening how lives of activists are sacrificed for farming. What about Chico, who was killed in cold blood over protecting people and their lands? The other side of the ground is bloodshed red. His legacy is being set on fire for the benefit of capitalism, and the very lands that are protected in the name of Chico are being illegally stripped down. On the other side, the sky is the color of arson. The fight for the Amazon to the indigenous guardians is a matter of life or death. You get shot down over rubber trees or sacrificed for protecting your property. On this side, I realize there is no other side. Even now, while the world's lungs are stuck at home, the planet's heart is failing. The Amazon's sensitive chambers can't be guarded in a pandemic. I pray that on the other side, green, wide, stretching forests don't burn down into graveyards. Inside my mind, hope paints pictures of tall rubber trees, green leaves and blue background of smoke-free skies, and green as far as the eyes can see. And everybody lives, and everybody breathes, and the forest breathes, and the trees breathe, and the Amazon breathes life into us in future generations. We can reverse this. Donate to Amazon Emergency Fund now.
Hello, I'm Chloe Smith from Rising Appalachia. I'm going to play you another song here. This song is called Speak Out. And it's about just that, standing up and speaking out when you see something that is going down, that it shouldn't be going down, or that you are passionate about and you want to bring forth into the world. And this, of course, is in solidarity with the Amazon and the people of the Amazon. So, here we go. Just step up, speak out, show up, be loud. 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 Be loud. Mind or a piece of the pie. 9 to 5 living in a plastic empire. Where is the house for the wounded and homeless? Can't sleep on the streets, can't afford to own this. Everything is me, my. Busy working for the dollar while the world runs dry. Minimum wages, maximum security. Simple pleasure traded for business and authority. Whoa. So step up, speak out, show up, be loud. Step up, speak out, show up, be loud. Step up, speak out, show up, be loud. Step up, speak out, show up, be loud.
Olá, sou Angela Mendes, filha do líder ambientalista Chico Mendes. O Brasil está vivendo um momento muito grave. A pandemia associada a um governo genocida que demonstra uma atitude criminosa e destruidora contra a Amazônia. Seguimos nos ideais do meu pai, lutando por uma aliança dos povos da floresta que unifique populações tradicionais e povos originários, e todos que acreditam e lutam por uma vida harmoniosa e sustentável dentro da floresta e que respeite a natureza e as pessoas que nela vivem. O desmatamento no Brasil cresceu 133% de janeiro a abril em relação ao mesmo período do ano de 2019. A maior floresta tropical do mundo está sendo destruída. Isso trará graves consequências para o planeta. Precisamos juntos lutar pela vida e pela Amazônia. Chico vive!
And then if I may prod you, if like one of these strands starts to go on a long time, to kind of move to the next one, because how many minutes do you think for this?
Are you talking to me?
No, I'm talking to Taylor. Okay. Sorry.
Well, you know.
with the packs and I'm going bring the wolves out. I've been in the jungle searching for that agua pura. It's a parecido to renacer under la luna. Flex and put in work with beauty, it's time to pay my dues. Now, oh, it's a shootout. There ain't no rule without a rule. Like they try to cook, they running the jewels, get removed. Yeah, who got the power? This for my world, it's for the future. Watch them bust a move, I'ma pass it off control now. Mama said be careful when you rolling with your crew now. Watch from kids whining as soon as they let the schools out. I just hit the lake with speed with a team. EG's, we been pushing mama's dream up on the scene. Land back to my people, that's all that we need. Hasta que el pueblo reclama todo el país. Juntando todos los colores del maíz. La flor de mi cultura latinoamericana. Mi gente del campo, morena, la tierra. Para todos mis hermanos, luchando en la selva, luchando en la guerra. O sea, todo el pueblo, somos las flechas. Culebras negras que tienen la cabeza. Protege la agua, sigue las abuelas. Ojos obsidianas con piel y canela. I'm seeing the vision. Running the mission, that's scotch in the rhythm. Can't doubt the precision. Too hot for the kitchen. They love how I'm switching. Idiomas somos palomas, suckers as chickens. Too real to run with any of these fake politicians. Selling that hole, my sister's been murdered and missing. We ain't riding a wave, we protecting our ways. We ain't leaving the land, we came from, we here to reclaim. Yeah, I'ma pass it out, watch us do it for the land. Yeah, cuentando las manos on my sonas, we gon' stand. Yeah, it's for the future, got our future in our hand. Yeah, watch us do it for my people, do it for the land.
Deforestation in the Brazilian rainforest has increased by 50% since the global pandemic took hold. Reduced oversight in remote regions has made it easier for loggers and mineral mining to go unchecked, which also increases the spread of the COVID-19. In this critical time of the international health crisis, protecting the heart of the planet is the same as protecting our own heart. Please join me in supporting the Amazon Emergency Fund and demand a halt to logging and mining on indigenous territories across the Amazon. This will not only help protect the rainforest, but it will help slow the introduction of COVID-19 into indigenous territories to help protect them as well. We can do this now, today, together. Thank you. Thank you very much. I look forward to this to happen with your help.
Hi, I'm Michi Sumner. I'm a mother, activist, and an actress. I'm so grateful you are here with us to support the Amazon Emergency Fund at this critical time. As we enter this new era of life with COVID, we must use this time for some much needed self-reflection. We cannot sustain our old way of living. Life cannot go back to normal. We must understand and we must acknowledge, as uncomfortable as it may be, our own complicity in consumerism and harmful policies that sustain the need for production, profit, and exploitation of Indigenous territory, Indigenous resources, and Indigenous peoples across the world. In a time when powerful government like the United States lack true leadership, failing their citizens as they choose economics over human lives, now is the time to listen to, learn from, and honor Indigenous leaders who are powerfully responding to this crisis as they organize to protect their communities, their ancestral lands, their children's future. We must fiercely support and stand in solidarity with the very people who are on the front lines guarding our sacred planet, protecting our future. Our actions make a difference. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Carlos Santana.
And Cindy Blackman Santana.
The impact of COVID-19 around the world in our neighborhoods and for many of us in our homes continues. More than 3.9 billion of us, nearly half the world's population, have been ordered to shelter in place.
COVID-19 has spread to indigenous communities in the Amazon and is having devastating effect. Over 100,000 cases have been confirmed in the Amazon already, and these figures will continue to grow exponentially without immediate action.
These communities are disproportionately vulnerable to the disease. These guardians of the forest, the wisdom keepers, need us to stand with them as they protect and defend the Amazon for all of us.
Destructive deforestation practices are accelerating and threatening to carry the virus deeper into indigenous lands.
We must stand and protect the protectors. When we do, we ensure the protection of the heart of the planet and ourselves. Please join me in supporting the Amazon's emergency fund and demand a halt to extractive activity and deforestation of indigenous territories across the Amazon. We can do this now.
Today.
Together. Thank you.
This is a song about a crossroads that we each face now more than ever. It's called What Happens Now.
The storm is worn, the edge is torn. The cut is gone, I must move on. The courage now I call is to rise above this wall. Oh, castles love, now they must fall. No compass in my empty hand. No footprints in the burning sand. I must trust this call. Whether I rise or fall, it's never let me down before. What happens now?
What happens now?
Hi, this is Peter Gabriel, and I'm in London and in lockdown, along with everyone else. This is a really strange time for everyone around the world. But the communities that are most vulnerable seem to be suffering a lot more than the rest of us. And this is to ask you to pay particular attention to all the indigenous peoples of the Amazon who've done a way better job over hundreds of years of looking after the rainforest than we have done. So we need an immediate moratorium on deforestation. People need to leave the Amazon that don't belong there straight away, and we need to campaign to look after those people that have done a brilliant job looking after the rainforest and its animal and human life and all the plants that may hold keys to our own future. Please support this Amazon Emergency Fund and the cry for a moratorium on deforestation. Thank you very much.
Yo soy Lisandro Cauper Peso, del pueblo Shipibo de la región Ucayali, actual presidente de IDCEP, que representa más de 2.000 comunidades en toda la Amazonía peruana, con 109 federaciones locales y 9 organizaciones regionales. Desde la Amazonía peruana, quiero informar la situación real que vive los pueblos indígenas amazónicos del Perú. La situación es crítica porque la pandemia COVID-19 ya llegó en nuestras comunidades y están contagiados, nuestros hermanos están muriendo, nuestros hermanos están en cama enfermos y eso nos preocupa bastante. Yo que viví en carne propia con esta enfermedad, con este virus COVID-19, me siento muy preocupado por mis hermanos y es por eso que nosotros hemos demandado, como también hemos propuesto al gobierno, a la estructura del Estado peruano, con una demanda de atención sanitaria inmediato diferenciada. Sin embargo, después de 70 días de cuarentena y estado declarado emergencia, recién se aprobó una resolución ministerial 308, pero eso está en documento, en un papel. Lo que se quiere es una inmediata intervención y implementación a las comunidades. Asimismo, quiero expresar que el gobierno peruano tiene que detener todas las actividades extractivas, todas las empresas mineras, forestales o petroleras, como por ejemplo Ocho Sur, que viene trabajando y corre pone en riesgo a nuestra población indígena de contagio. Igualmente la empresa petrolera Geopar. Nosotros más de 500 años venimos contribuyendo como pueblos indígenas al mundo, conservando, protegiendo nuestra biodiversidad y nuestros territorios como un sistema de control y vigilancia territorial ancestral. Eso permite que los pueblos indígenas estamos contribuyendo con el mundo. Finalmente, quiero llamar atención a la comunidad internacional que nos sigan apoyando en esta pandemia que vivimos, que su fondo está llegando hacia las comunidades a través de nuestras federaciones y organizaciones regionales con víveres o con algunos medicamentos. Muchas gracias.
Thank you, Peter, and thank you all so much for tuning in. My name is Leila Salazar Lopez, and I am the Executive Director of Amazon Watch. As you've heard, the Amazon and its peoples are in a state of emergency right now due to the ongoing invasions of indigenous territories, climate change, and now the COVID-19 pandemic. And as every day passes, the novel coronavirus spreads across the Amazon basin and the possibility of ethnocide becomes more real. As of May 27th, there are over 134,000 reported cases and nearly 7,000 deaths due to COVID-19 across the Amazon basin. In Brazil alone, we know of 147 indigenous lives that have been taken by COVID. Over 1,300 have been reported. It's likely these numbers are much higher and will increase as long as business as usual continues. So that's why over 200 international organizations have joined a call of indigenous peoples across the Amazon in calling for an immediate moratorium on any activity that includes the entering of foreigners into indigenous lands, such as logging, mining, oil extraction or exploration, agribusiness expansion, religious proselytization, or increased militarization. We demand that Amazonian governments and the corporations doing business there immediately cease all destructive and extractive activities on indigenous lands. We demand that financiers like BlackRock and JP Morgan Chase stop funding the destruction of the Amazon and our global climate. What's happening right now in the Amazon is a crime against nature, and it's a crime against humanity. It's time for all of us to unite and act in defense of the forest and in solidarity with the indigenous and traditional peoples across the Amazon who are protecting this great rainforest and our climate for all of us, for our children, for your children, for all of humanity and all of life on Earth. Please join us in taking action for a moratorium today at amazonwatch.org. Thank you again so much for joining us. And now let's hear another song from our dear brother, Nako.
Give gratitude to everyone that organized this event, to all participants, and of course to you all listening and watching. In a time where we're being challenged so greatly across so many spectrums of life, the power of music can bring us together, remind us of our humanness and our connectedness. This song's called Give It All. Thank you for watching. Every dollar counts to help our relatives in the Amazon. Please donate, will you? Time to pull out my paints. Brand new canvas, get things straight. There are no lines here. Double rainbows make great lakes. Coda spoke Anishinaabe. She is a key bear. Let her open. Everywhere I see stress. Wonder what we gonna lose next. Well, it won't be sweet love, cause it's my lesson, it's my teacher. Malcolm X or Martin Luther. And I am neither. Perfect world, what is this? Does it even exist? Would I live there? If I can learn to be alone, I will always have a home. Give it all you got. Give it all God. All you've gained and all you've lost. And that's a lot. Yeah, that's a lot. Da 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 da. No, no, no. Dharma bumps from the Catskills to San Juan with just an atlas. Well, it was magic. Thank you, Paul, for those directions. Oh, the bridge or any yellow shine. Those troubled waters, no longer silence in the dreaming Uluru. I brought me singing to me and casting lines to Palestine and Altinoa, my Wadua. It's nice to know life like that from the Mount of Sandy Rock. There were moments I got lost. Denominators, so fuck the haters. Park high down Ecuador, standing room on the jungle floor. Can't take our language, can't drink the oil. Lost a baby, lost a friend. Some days my family's lost again. To the trauma, to the war, that's how I learned to be alone. Coming from a broken home, that's how I learned to be alone. Coming from a broken home, give me all you got. Give me all you got. We'll make stories, we'll make love, and that's enough. Yeah, that's enough. Do da 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 da.
Bomatum, my relatives, my name is Nako, and I appreciate you showing up in the ways that you can for our relatives in the Amazon, and giving thanks for this opportunity to share my kuleana with you all. Take care.
Well, I hope you're feeling the forest. I hope you're feeling the hearts of the people and purpose for this gathering, because we're not just here to make money and to raise money for the Amazon Emergency Fund. You know, we are bringing you the best information from the world's foremost experts and leaders. We're bringing you music from the world's most talented and passionate artists, and images that plunge you deep into the forest itself. We're bringing you the messages direct from the forest as well. And this is a collaborative effort. This is all of us together. It's all of us here on the team, but it's all of you as well. So stay with us, you know, for more of everything. And I wanted to tell you something that's pretty cool that Joaquin Phoenix and Moby helped to do to support the Amazon rainforest here in Los Angeles. So Los Angeles City Council voted to become the first city in the whole country to officially say no to beef, soybeans, and furniture that comes directly from deforested rainforest in Brazil. That's amazing. So no beef, no soybeans, and no furniture comes from harming the rainforest in Brazil. This is a really big deal, and yet it's a very obvious thing to do right now. So your city can do the same. Your city can also divest from ecological destruction and the ethnocide of indigenous peoples in Brazil. And you can make them do it. This is the thing. These things only happen if we acquiesce, if we consent. but we can ask for something different. So on November 3rd, on Election Day, you can vote for the Amazon by electing leaders who will commit right now to follow LA's lead and enact the Amazon divestment legislation in your city and your country as well, actually, all over the world. And on that note, I wanted to introduce a really formidable leader who has been working from the age of 10 to defend the people and the forest of his region in Acre, Brazil. His name is Benki Bianco, and he's an Ashaninka leader. He's also the indigenous director of the Boa Foundation, which is an organization that I'm a part of that works with 40 indigenous elders from all over the world and fundraises for their projects and their causes as well. And he sent us a message from the heart of his rainforest in the Yorenka Tassarensi Center.
Então, quero passar essa mensagem, né, para o mundo como uma reflexão de uma grande expectativa que a gente hoje está tendo pelo grande problema na Amazônia. Tivemos nesses últimos anos, né, grandes ataques, né, que vieram pela destruição da floresta causada pelas queimadas, a seca que nos afetou de uma maneira muito violenta em muitos lugares do Brasil e também pela própria contaminação das fumaças que atingiu muitas pessoas no Brasil e assim também no mundo. Eu acredito que todos esses problemas que vêm ocorrendo com as queimadas, né, com a seca dos rios, principalmente nesse momento, né, que nós estamos passando do verão, que é uma época da seca, nós temos hoje uma grande preocupação nesse ano, porque nós sabemos que a fumaça ela traz para a nossa vida uma grande intoxicação quando é queimado a floresta. E a gente sabe que tudo isso afeta diretamente os povos indígenas com a gripe, com diarreia, com tantas outras, né, doenças que vêm em cima desse grande calor que afeta os povos indígenas. E hoje, olhando para tudo isso que pode vir nesse ano, pode ser um problema muito mais grave pela queimada, porque a gente vê que hoje a coronavírus, essa doença que hoje está aí vindo, né, de uma tal maneira, causando pânico à sociedade, causando pânico aos povos indígenas, causando pânico à humanidade. Primeiro, porque não tem nenhum remédio. Segundo, porque os povos indígenas têm uma fragilidade muito grande por ser os povos indígenas mais... menos, né, favorecidos pela saúde, pela própria o Estado, né? Nós temos uma grande dificuldade nisso. E acreditamos que os povos que hoje estão sendo afetados no Brasil, na Amazônia, vai trazer uma grande dificuldade, né, para todos nós, povos indígenas, porque nós vamos acabar perdendo as nossas lideranças, os nossos velhinhos, nossos anciões, por conta dessa doença, assim como a gente foi afetado em outras doenças, em outras épocas no passado, né? E essa pode ser uma que nós podemos perder os nossos anciões, e nós temos uma grande preocupação nessa defesa, né, de poder fazer a prevenção com nossos povos indígenas, cuidar das nossas comunidades, defender os nossos territórios. E acreditamos que isso não vai afetar apenas só os nossos povos indígenas, mas como também vai afetar o mundo inteiro se a gente tiver uma queimada violenta como tivemos o ano passado, e que esse ano a gente espera que a gente possa ter aí, né, através dos parceiros, amigos, países que hoje também pretendem a defender junto com nós, defensores, né, das florestas, defensores dos nossos territórios, defensores da terra, porque nós fomos e somos os únicos mais defensores de toda a história desse planeta, que falamos sinceramente, com tanta sinceridade para o mundo, que a grande violência que está vindo ao planeta, o planeta hoje pode ser explodido em uma grande defasa, né, que hoje pode vir aí a partir dessa queimada que pode ocorrer na Terra. Então isso para nós queremos, né, contar com cada um parceiro desse, com cada um governo, porque o nosso governo hoje a gente sabe que está causando para a gente uma grande violência contra os nossos pensamentos, as nossas visões de mundo, porque tudo isso que vem acontecendo na terra é uma grande preocupação que não acarreta a vida só de índio, mas também a vida de toda a humanidade do planeta. Eu sou Benk Pianco, sou do povo Axaninka, sou uma liderança que represento hoje, né, essa visão mais ampla que integra hoje o povo Axaninka na proteção dos nossos direitos, dos nossos territórios.
Hello, thank you very much for being here. And I suppose a question at the moment on the planet we are all forced to ask ourselves is how hard is it to breathe without the cooperation of your lungs? And it would follow we should ask the same question of how will this planet breathe without its lungs, the Amazon? And so let's think of them that way when we're wondering about how much we need to do or what we need to do. We must take care of them, I think. Emergency.
Nine planets around the sun, only one does the sun embrace. And upon this watered one, so much we take for granted. So let us sleep outside tonight, lay down in our mother's arms, for here we can rest safely. Dry, would it stop our stepping feet? Oh, let us sleep outside tonight, lay down in our mother's arms, for here we can rest safely. Take all that we can get.
Thank you, everybody. I hope you're doing good.
25% of the world's medicines come from the Amazon and other tropical rainforests. The cure for this pandemic and possible future ones could, in fact, come from there. When we protect the land and the indigenous peoples who have the traditional knowledge of the health of these forests, we protect ourselves too. Please join me in supporting the Amazon Emergency Fund and demand a halt to extractive activity and deforestation on indigenous territories across the Amazon.
My name is Koryanka Kilcher. I'm descendant of the Quechua Machipaita people from the highlands and jungles of South America. And I've actually been doing a lot of work since I'm 16 with grassroots youth groups all throughout the Peruvian Amazon, which is why what is happening right now with the COVID-19 in Peru is very scary and very sad, because like the wildfires that we, you know, saw happening all throughout the Amazon, COVID-19 is spreading like a wildfire. And one of the reasons that it is spreading that way is because there is no, most of the communities are very rural. They don't have access to internet. They only are able to get information from listening to the radio. They don't have the support of the government. All of the communities are in dire need right now of being educated, one, about what's COVID-19, because by the time that they even begin to understand what is COVID-19, what is actually happening, entire communities are already affected. I mean, there is a community of Pukakuro, I think it's called, and it has 800 inhabitants, and out of those 800 inhabitants of people living there, 600 of them are infected with the COVID-19 virus. And, you know, this is a real emergency, because also what is happening is a lot of communities and a lot of families are starting to starve to death as well, because in order for it, because they're having complete like lockdowns by military and police who are patrolling the streets, ensuring that no one can leave their, you know, their houses. And the only way that you can leave your house is if you have a permit. But the only way that you can get a permit is by having access to internet, which most of the communities in the more rural areas do not have any access to computers or the internet. So they are unable to get the permit. And if you go leave your house without the permit, you get detained. So families are starting to starve. People are not having enough information about what is actually happening. Most of the support and aid never reaches the more rural communities. They mostly help the bigger towns and cities. And, you know, people are starting to really die and starve to death because of this virus. And right now, it is an emergency, and they, you know, people like to say the Peruvian Amazon is the lungs of the earth, and, you know, indigenous people's lifestyles are based on environmentally sustainable principles and practices without destroying their children's future. But right now, the oxygen there is not enough. They're needing oxygen in tanks. And, you know, I know that briefly, I know that my friend, two of my friends, they have COVID-19 right now because they're reporters and they've been trying to get information out. And as they've been reaching out to the communities, going to the communities, trying to get information, trying to share the information, they contracted coronavirus, and their entire family has coronavirus now too. And, you know, they need food. They need medical attention. I know my friend, the Apu, the leader of the tribe, called him yesterday and told him that some medical team came into their community with only 5 corona tests, and all 5 of them were positive. So there is a complete lack of support from the government. There's a complete lack of medical, like, there is 8 brave doctors in Iquitos who didn't have the proper safety equipment, who didn't have the proper, you know, protection, and they all died. So if our doctors are dying there, who is going to help there? If they are not given the necessary things to just be able to protect themselves so that they can at least try to help and treat other people with coronavirus, like, there's something really scary, very wrong, and our brothers and sisters in Peru need our support now more than ever before, because like I said earlier, this is like spreading like a wildfire, like we saw a few months ago in the Amazon, and There is no potential stop or end to this because the lack of education and the lack of protection and the lack of medical necessities that are needed to treat this pandemic. So several of my friends, two of them, Bernab and Italo, who are both reporters, who both were on the front lines, really trying to get information about what COVID-19 is so that they can actually share it and spread it through the radio. And they were, you know, in direct contact, going to all the different communities, really trying to reach out to them. They actually contracted coronavirus themselves, and their whole families have it now. So, you know, I asked them to send over two videos because I think it's important for everyone to hear from them on the ground, dealing with it in a daily basis. They have it, to really hear what they have to say, because this is a serious crisis, and until this crisis is addressed, more and more people are going to continue to die at a very rapid, scary speed. So there's going to be a few videos from my friend Bernab and Italo, and there's going to be hopefully a couple other videos that you guys will be able to see.
Buenas tardes, mi nombre es Daniel Vela Collantes, jefe de la comunidad nativa Matzés. Estoy acá varado con los hermanos Matzés en la ciudad de Quito. Como jefe de la comunidad nativa Matzés, les pedimos tu colaboración para poder atender a los hermanos Matzés que están en esta ciudad para cubrir sus necesidades por los alimentos, por el alojamiento, por las medicinas, porque algunos ya están enfermos. Para poder enfrentar a esta enfermedad, para poder estar durante estos días de cuarentena, necesitamos tu colaboración, que nos apoye con buen corazón a los hermanos Matzés. Gracias.
Soy Italo García Murayari, comunicador social del pueblo Shipibo Conigo. Llevo 32 días contagiado por este mal, COVID-19. Hace poco me han detectado a mí y a 5 de mi familia. Vivo en carne propia vivir de esta enfermedad. Así como yo, los comunicadores indígenas estamos sumergidos a eso. Comunicadores indígenas que se han contagiado, cubriendo, informando a las comunidades indígenas en sus respectivos programas de radio. Así como nosotros, las comunidades nativas están sufriendo mucho, porque hasta el momento no tienen apoyo de parte del gobierno, apoyo por la parte médica, apoyo de nuestras autoridades de turno del gobierno regional de Ucayali. La población indígena sufre mucho en esta parte de la Amazonía de Perú. Esta pandemia los ha golpeado demasiado. Estamos hablando hasta el momento de 66 hermanos shipibos muertos aquí en la región de Ucayali, por falta de atención, por falta de atención del Estado. Mis hermanos están muriendo. Hay muchas iniciativas que hablan de la recaudación de grandes fondos en mira a la Amazonía peruana, en mira a la región Ucayali. No sabemos si estos apoyos llegan verdaderamente a la población indígena en Ucayali. Pero a veces también se aprovechan de este mal por recaudar grandes fondos, simplemente llegan a sus allegados, simplemente llegan a unos cuantos en la ciudad, pero en las comunidades nativas es lo que necesita más. Hay personas que están muriendo no solamente del virus. Hay personas que están muriendo de hambre. Y algunas ONGs, algunos entes del Estado, del gobierno, hasta el momento no se fijan. Si han llegado en grandes cantidades los apoyos, yo pido que lleguen netamente a las comunidades nativas, en esa lejanía de las comunidades nativas en toda la región de Ucayali. Estamos hablando más de 166 comunidades nativas albergadas a lo largo y ancho de la región de Ucayali. Encarecidamente les pido a las personas que están dando iniciativa de recaudar fondos que lleguen verdaderamente a nuestros hermanos, porque esta pandemia los ha golpeado duramente a los hermanos indígenas de toda la región Ucayali.
Não estão sabendo o que nós está passando aqui no Vale do Javari.
Greed is what has driven the invasion of other people's lands over the course of human history. In the past 30 years, we've lost 17% of the Brazilian Amazon.
This jungle, these waters, they have been in my life for a long time. When I was 9 years old, I went to the Amazon with my grandfather. 25 years later, I returned to the Amazon. Oil spills, dams breaking and leaking toxic sludge, and the government compromising indigenous rights. If they disappear, so will that rainforest.
Morrendo nossos parentes.
A saúde que está uma situação crítica. Em atendimento à saúde das populações indígenas.
We can't change history. We can't change the past. But we can make a better future by knowing our own past, what we've done, what we could have done differently, how we feel about it, and how we act on it today based on what the past teaches us.
We do not need to repeat history. If I truly believed in community and the interconnection of people in the world, I had to help tell his people's story. I had to go back to the jungle.
The Amazon became part of my life when I was 9 years old. I went there with my grandfather on his expedition, exploring ecosystems, species, and people. 25 years later, I returned on another expedition with my father to document what had happened in those 25 years. It is then that I met the people of the Vale do Javari indigenous territory in the Brazilian Amazon. They asked me to tell their story. I created a film called Tribes on the Edge in response to their call. But I realized that telling a story was not enough. Tangible action is necessary. From there, my work has expanded to responding to other needs defined by the indigenous people themselves, actions that will support the people of the Javari on the ground. This is called the Javari Project. Please join me in supporting the Amazon Emergency Fund and demand a halt to extractive activity and deforestation on indigenous territories across the Amazon. We can do this now. Today and together. Thank you.
Blood will flow
flesh and steel are one, drying on the color of the evening sun. Tomorrow's rain will wash the stains away, but something in our mind will always stay. Perhaps this final act was meant to clinch our lifetime's argument that nothing come from violence and nothing ever could. For all those born beneath an angry star, lest we forget how fragile we are. On and on the rain will fall like tears from the star, like tears from the star. On and on the rain will say how fragile we are, how fragile we are.
Thank you all for being with us today in this Artists United for Amazonia live stream. My name is Atossa Soltani. I'm the founder of Amazon Watch.
And my name is Lynn Twist, and I'm the co-founder of the Pachamama Alliance.
We are delighted to see this historic expression of unification and coalition, bringing together artists, activists, indigenous peoples, and organizations from around the world to stand in solidarity with the protectors of the Amazon basin. I've been working in the Amazon for nearly 30 years, and I have just never seen such coming together of people for this critical moment where indigenous peoples and many communities are facing this emergency, the COVID emergency. And the time is now to unite and support the Amazon Emergency Fund, which is making direct grants to communities in the front lines in response to this COVID emergency. And we're doing it in partnership. And the fund is a partnership with Indigenous peoples, and it is led by them. The governing council of the fund is made up of majority Indigenous peoples to help guide where the funding is needed most.
You know, this is such an unprecedented time for all of us. And the Amazon rainforest, as Atossa said, and she and I have been working there for decades. We are Amazon sisters, you might say. We've been down there. We've been with the indigenous people. There is such an awesome power coming through them, particularly now as the Amazon reaches a kind of dangerous, dangerous tipping point. It's the vital organ of our planet. It's the heart and lungs of our planet. And they, the indigenous people, across those nine countries, larger than the United States is the Amazon rainforest, are the natural custodians of these forests. And this fund, the AmazonEmergencyFund.org, that's where you go to donate, is a fund that we're determined to raise $5 million by July 1st. And we want you to participate with us. We would like every single person within the sound of our voice right now to make a donation, large or small. We like large, but small's okay too, to the AmazonEmergencyFund.org. That's where you go to donate. And be in partnership with all these artists, these incredible scientists, all the people who've come together to put this amazing program together. Join them and us and the indigenous peoples of the Amazon you'll be investing not only in an emergency fund, but in the long-term future of life. These Indigenous people are protecting those forests, not only for themselves, but for you and I, and for the long-term future of life. That's the investment to make right now, today. Do not hesitate. Go straight to AmazonEmergencyFund.org and make your donation right away.
And you can be sure that 100% of every donation will go directly in grants to support front lines, to support emergency evacuation, masks, testing, food systems, protection of territories, protection of leaders. You know, deforestation in the Amazon is actually on the rise while we're all in sheltering in place. Deforestation is actually accelerating in the Amazon. And we basically have no time to lose. This is the moment to come together in an unprecedented fashion to unite in supporting and standing in solidarity with Indigenous peoples who not only are the best stewards of the Amazon, they also have a lot of wisdom to teach us about how to live in harmony with nature, how to live in harmony with the living systems of our planet. And we must protect the protectors and unite as a global movement. This is just the beginning of this global movement. And we're very excited that you're joining us. And now, don't wait till tomorrow. Do it today. Help us have an incredible impact. Go to AmazonEmergencyFund.org and be part of our movement. Thank you.
Donate today. Don't hesitate. Go for it. Thank you.
Of the world I see, I will use vibrant colors, paint over every hatred. Oh, for high is the price we all will have to pay for generations' mistakes. Could it be this kind of a world, only believe in black and white? Or is it too late? Tell me what you're gonna do. You're living in public view. You're reading everybody's news. Morning, 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 man. Tell me what you're gonna do. I know you got a million views. You're reading everybody's news. Morning, 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 man. High on the tower of social media, nobody seems to care. Artificial intelligence and false messiahs rising to fill the spaces. Oh, for those who know I'm right, who know there comes a cost to learn. Could it be this colorful world only could see in black and white? Or we need more of the same? Tell me what you're gonna do. You're living in public view. You're reading everybody's news. Morning, 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 man. Tell me what you're gonna do. I know you got a million views. You're reading everybody's news. Morning, 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 man. Morning, morning woman too. Morning woman too. Morning woman too. Morning woman too. Morning woman too.
Spanish news. Morning, 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 morning. What you gonna do? You're living in public view. Whoa.
Begins to emerge from this pandemic, embarking on putting lives and economies back on their feet, we have an unprecedented opportunity and obligation to do things differently and better. Indigenous peoples have been teaching us for thousands of years that our own survival and the survival of all living things is fundamentally tied to the health of our environment. Decisions we make every day can be the difference between thriving together and destroying our most fundamental link to our planet. When we protect the protectors, we protect ourselves.
Hi, I'm Suzanne Pelletier, the Executive Director of the Rainforest Foundation US. We're proud to be part of the founding circle of the Amazon Emergency Fund. So thank you so much for joining in this important event today. Next month, on June 21st, the Rainforest Foundation, along with our sister organizations in the UK and Norway, will be joining together in a live stream music event called SOS Rainforest Live. The event will raise awareness and funds to protect tropical forests and indigenous peoples under threat to COVID-19 in Asia, Africa, and Latin America. The event is a call to action and will feature performances by musicians, including our founder Sting, and indigenous leaders from across the world. So we hope that you'll join us on June 21st at 3 p.m. Eastern Time. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Wow, it's been such a trip to see all of these incredible images and to hear all of these messages. You know, I've certainly got a real sense of the care, the level of care that every single one of our messengers has for the thriving of life and the care for our planet and for beauty and for diversity. Both cultural diversity and biological diversity. And we know in our hearts in this way that love is actually the answer, because through this aspect of care and through this love vibration, I guess, that's what actually turns us on to stand together in this way. And with all my heart, I know that this is a really big time of transformation. And change is really hard. It's not easy. It's uncomfortable. And the thing is, it's inevitable right now. So it's just a question of whether we do it consciously or whether we just spiral further into chaos. And the thing is, COVID has been a global game changer. We're all locked up in our heart and in our houses with an opportunity to think. And we have changed so many things that we thought were impossible to shift out of fear. But can we change them out of love, out of joy? You know, can we humbly accept as well that we don't know a lot of things, that pretending that we do or expecting other people and hoping that other people do is actually really cowardly and pointless? And so can we gaze into the mystery and feel wonder and feel awe? And can we look around as well and not see this pyramid of creation with human beings sort of perched on top, eating everything else, but rather feel a part of this magnificent creation of all of this life, of this miracle, perfect planet that we travel through space in? And can we take care of it? Can we take care of ourselves? Can we take care of one another? Take good care. Because this global pause begs the question, how do we want to step back out into the world, right? What kind of world do we want to step back out into? And what do you value? What do you hold dear to your heart? And who are you? And what do you love? And this live stream and the Amazon Emergency Fund, this is a shining example of the kind of collaboration that is possible right now that this crisis is calling for. 200 organizations coming together for a common cause. And it's been a real honor to spend this time with all of you. Thank you so much for watching and for tuning in. Please spread this message. Please tell your friends and your loved ones to join us in protecting the heart of this planet. And when we do, we protect all of us. We protect everything. It's all us. So we're going to end a little bit like we began, with a message of healing. Yakon Rata is a Shipibo Kaniba great-grandmother healer. What a legend. The song that she's going to offer, it's a cleansing to our homes, to our bodies, and a call for help from the spirit world and the spirits of the plants of the forest to heal and protect the elders and all the creatures across the Amazon.
Nokaya Madiba, 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 Nokaya Madi I've never been to the Amazon rainforest, but I know that we all have to work together to stand with the indigenous communities that have protected the forest, which is the heart of the planet, and they've protected it for thousands of years. While these guardians of the forest are under constant assault from a government that sees the richness of the land and its resources as commodities to be mined, drilled, and cut down for profit, it is up to us, the world community, to face our own responsibility in all of this. The wisdom keepers of the rainforest have always known that we all belong to the earth and that we are all responsible in different ways for its health. That when the forest is ravaged by fires, as we all witnessed last summer, the weather systems, the temperatures of the world's oceans, and the air we breathe are all affected. If nothing else, this global pandemic has made it crystal clear that we are all connected, that whatever happens over there, wherever there is, affects what happens here in our home, in our community, to our neighbors and loved ones, and in our country as a whole. This virus doesn't know any there or here. The Amazon, listen to this, it's very important. The Amazon is responsible for providing 20% of the world's oxygen. 25% of the world's medicines come from there and other tropical forests. It's possible that the cure for this pandemic and potential future ones could in fact come from there as well. And I love this fact that there are more trees in the Amazon than stars in the Milky Way. Hopefully with this broadcast, we have brought you a little closer to the Amazon and to the role we must all play, no matter where we are, in joining with the guardians of this vast and vital forest that protects us every day from those that are destroying it. Yes, it's about climate change, and it's about the destruction of thousands of years of an ecosystem that feeds the world's atmosphere with fresh air and water. And most of all, it is about the people who live side by side with the animals and the trees and carry the knowledge of its secrets and the known incalculable role it plays in sustaining the life of our planet. Many are calling for this to be a time when we consider what the future could look like if the health of the planet, the health of the global economy and our personal health are seen as all connected. If we begin to emerge from this time with a commitment to forge a new future, where opportunities to serve our global well-being and our economic health are finally in partnership, then we will have taken a big step toward forging a better future for all of us. We are all connected now. And perhaps that is what this virus is teaching us, that we are all responsible for each other in ways we hadn't seen before, when we protect ourselves by protecting each other. So please join me in supporting the Amazon Emergency Fund and demand a halt to extractive activity and deforestation on indigenous territories across the Amazon. We can do this. We really can make a difference today, now, together. Thank you.
We can do this.
We can do this.
We can do this.
Now.
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 Today.
Today.
Together.
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 We can do this.
We can do this.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's make sure what we do now will make future generations thrive. The fate of Amazonia affects everyone. So please, take a deep breath, think of the Amazon rainforest, and support the Amazon Emergency Fund. Let's not lose the people of the trees. Let's not lose the Amazon rainforest. Come on, man. We're all in this together. Yeah.
Yes, Jeff. We are all in this together. Thank you guys so much. I wanted to offer a little song as well from the Huniquin people of the Amazon rainforest. These are my first teachers that I met. And this is one of their songs, and it's just calling for all of the wisdom of all of the universe come to us now, and all of the wisdom of nature and all of the wisdom of the stars and the wisdom of the rainbow and the color yellow and all of the wisdom. So it's calling on all of this wisdom to come to us now. Vaishnava Maria, Vaishnava Maria, Vaishnava Maria, Vaishnava Maria, Yuvena Yuvia, Yuvena Yuvia, Yuvena Yuvia, Nawa Unishani, 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 Again, please do not hesitate to donate at the AmazonEmergencyFund.org. Do it now. Let's be together now. Thank you.